What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another drawing tutorial. So today we have Mirko. This is a Patreon request. Mirko from My Hero Academia. So, right, so landscape orientation page, use a pencil, hit pause if I go too fast. So we're gonna start with her eyes. So we've got two hands up and she's got that bunny sort of pose. It's the best sort of one I could find, the most straightforward one I could find. All the rest are kind of her, like, big kicks and all that, really complicated sort of poses and stuff. So this is like the easiest one I could find, and because there's two hands in it, it's probably still kind of a bit tricky, so take your time, right? So center point of my page is probably maybe here, I think, and that's probably where her nose is, or just like a bit lower maybe. So because she's got like big ears, her eyes are just in line just with the center point of my page, right? So along this horizontal line. So center point right here, and just to the right of that, we're gonna start with her eyes. And she just has like big curvature on her eyes, like this, right? And some of this, of course, does go underneath her hair. So, you know, don't worry too much about this portion because some of her hair covers it, right? So, you can thicken this line up a little bit. Well, like a good bit of thickness on it, I guess. Just here. And at the end, so she can have big, long sort of eyelashes sticking off. It's underneath her hair, so we'll just add a small one, just so we don't have to erase. But if you want to make it longer, we can at the end. It's not like a big deal. So then, so bottom eyelid then comes down here. So real big sort of eyes, like so. And then this is gonna come like straight across, like that, okay? So thick on this side and then thin going across, okay? Okay, and then in here we have iris and before that, she has some eyelashes, a little bit sticking off the bottom. So like some sticking out here, maybe one there, just a couple going up here as well, like that, sorry. A couple more eyelashes and then her iris. So circle, we can see the whole eye. So, and then I think she has like long eyes. They're not sort of standard eyes, are they? Yeah, they're like long sort of eyes. So like in the middle, what I mean is like kind of like a cat, like this kind of thing. Those kind of eyes, not like circles, okay? Okay, so then her other eye. So My Hero Academia eyes were not in proportion. So like her other eye starts about there. So it's probably, her whole eye is like too big to fit inside there. So the distance between her two eyes is smaller than this eye when you're drawing it, okay? So it's probably 3/4 of her eye could maybe fit in here, or 2/3. You know? So this distance is smaller than this eye. So probably cut this bit off and that could probably fit in there. Okay, it's just because My Hero Academia eyes are much bigger than standard. So just bear that in mind. So then we will curve over. Like so. And we can add the big spiking part. And this one we're actually going to make super long because it's big, it's long in the picture. It's not long on the other side, maybe it's hidden under her hair. Like that. If you want to make that side long to make it even, you could if you wanted. Just thickening up the top eyelid now. Like so. Do you know what? Maybe I will make this longer as well. Just, it's kind of looks like it should be, really. Let's do it. And then her back of her eye just here comes down like so. And then we'll bring this across pretty straight, across like so. And then again, we'll add some eyelashes, some triangles sort of sticking off here. And some coming out the bottom. So, and then her iris, again, circle. Of course, if you would like a compass or something that you could draw around, feel free. And then do a sort of a long cat-like eye inside there. Right, so then she has like an eyelid line just above her eye, curving around like so. Same on this side. She could have some actually extra eyelash lines just sticking off here as well. And then her nose, real easy, just a line in the middle of her face between her eyes, down like that. And she's like, she's making like a rabbit face, like showing her teeth. So she could have like some sort of bumps on one side of her face like that. So that mouth, right? So she's her mouth is wide and we can see like nearly all of her teeth, right? So we're gonna curve this around here, and it's skinnier on this side, right? So it's like skinnier here. Okay, and we're like underneath the inside of her iris, just like here. You don't want to go much further than that. Don't go further than her iris and pupil. Right, so then we're gonna join those together. So we go down like so. Kind of a curved line there. And then we go around underneath the bottom lip, like that, okay? So in there then we can see like teeth, right? So we can see a bit of a shadow on this side. And then there's some lines for teeth coming across. Like so. And you're only kind of suggesting teeth lines. You're not like drawing a full line across. That's the main thing to remember when you're doing something like this. It's just like that. And then on top, we can see like, so say in the middle, we can see like her gums, right? So you can see like a shadow of a gum here. And then this is going to curve around the tooth here. And we have another one. So like these are her gums bumping around her teeth here. And then back up, back into there. So there's some side teeth just there, and maybe like another one going back that way, and then something sort of here, and then coming down this way. And maybe some gum as well here. Like so. So I know not the easiest. I'm just going to shade in her gums just so we can distinguish them from her teeth. That kind of thing, okay? So if you make them darker, it makes them stand out more. So if you're using a pencil, you could shade them in gray. Okay, so her chin, just down here. So curves around, like so. And you can check proportions now. So like the eyes to the top of her mouth there is about the same as the top of the mouth to the chin. Okay, so here to here is about the same as here to here. So this is about halfway, top of her teeth is halfway between her pupil and her chin. So this is the same as this. This, same as this. Okay, so that's your proportion. And then once you get that, you'll go up side of the jaw. Okay, and about underneath her eye, you'll start to turn. So like underneath here, see? We're gonna start to turn and go up the side of her face. Okay. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Like so, and about here, underneath her eye, you turn and go up. We're not going to go up as far this side because we have a load of hair on this side, so you can stop just there. Okay. So her hair comes up around the side of her face, and it just goes up to the top of her head. So it's like where they sort of cross over is like a V just here. Okay. Slightly over to the left. It's not like bang in the middle. A little bit over to the left. And if you're wondering how high up, this area to her top eyelid is about the same as her top eyelid to the bottom of her mouth. So then this is going to curve down. Like so, real big long piece of hair. Goes all the way down. Right to the bottom of my page. So this, and then this spike will come back up. Big, long piece of hair all the way up to about there. Okay. So that's what I meant, like a lot of this eye is covered, okay? So the other side then will come down here. This side isn't as long because it goes behind her body down here. So it like stops about there. But the other side then will come up so, right up into here. So this is like where the top of her head is as well. So she's real big forehead. Sorry, Mirko. But so this is like the curved line for the top of her head here. She's got some hairlines and texture lines coming out, coming down like so. Some texture lines on this side as well. But we'll erase actually those pieces of I first. So a couple of more texture lines just on her head. Coming down here. Like so, and we'll do her eyebrows. We forgot her eyebrows. So like just a curved line here. With another side to it, like so. Around there, and up here. Right, so what can we see next? Right, so we'll do so we can see a full big long ear on this side, right? So it curves up like so. And then we will bring it back down around this side. Okay, kind of a bump here. So like another piece of her ear comes down like so. Down past her eyelash. Down into there. They're kind of furry at the bottom, so they've got like spikes for fur just coming down underneath her hair and into her cheek just down there. And there could be some like hatching. Like that. So she's got a hand on that side and a hand on this side. So the hand on this side is in front of the ear, except for like maybe the side of it. So we can just see one side of this ear and then the hand covers the rest, okay? So this ear goes all the way up top of my page. Comes back down and then hits her hand about here, okay? So, yeah, we'll add her hand first, right? So this is tricky, so take your time. So, side of her hand here. It's like a glove, right? Comes down to there and comes across. It's got two V's. Across to there, another V, like so, and then the other side of it, just here, okay? And then we got like a bump or two, like a fold, coming across her wrist. So she's like doing this kind of thing, sticking her hands out from her ears, right? So, let's see. So, palm of her hand, just there. Four fingers. So, I guess we just do them one at a time. So, little finger comes up like so, curves around into there. Next one. Goes down around like so, top of her finger just here, top of the next finger is here, and then it comes down in a similar fashion, curving down like so. So really take your time with this now, because not easy. You know, pause it, try and figure it out. And then top of the next finger curves down, comes around here like so, and then side of this finger Comes down right by her ear there. And then this will come down towards her thumb. So her thumb is kind of like sticking off this way. So it's like it's foreshortened. So it's kind of stumpy looking, right? So it like curves around there. And then comes down this side. Back up that side. Around. Down and in. So you could like thicken up some of these lines. And it's because they're gloves, right? There is some stitching sort of lines on top. Like that. Just on top of each finger. And on top of her thumb as well. Just like a line that kind of curves around. Can't see it on her little finger, but I'll add it anyway. Just because it would make more sense if it was there. And then a line for the palm of her hand, sort of coming around that way. Like so, and it's just some more sort of folds on her glove. You know, you could add some hatching in here. Just to give it a bit of shadow. There's lines on the top of these triangles on the bottom of the glove there. And then that line on her thumb is there as well. Okay, so I think that makes sense. I hope it does anyway. Looks like a hand, right? Okay, so so like her arm comes out from here, so like big line like so, big sort of curving line, so curves in and out and then goes around her elbow down here. If you do it at sort of angles, it's easier. So go down to there and then change direction and then change direction again and then to there, and then this is kind of going, so like the other side of her arm is here, like that. Okay, right, so it's kind of floating there at the minute, but we'll add like her body, the side of her body, and this is like her elbow just there. And then her tricep will kind of go around. So she's pretty muscly. So like this goes around like so. And then her shoulder is here somewhere. Like that. So that shoulder looks like it's kind of just floating there at the minute, but to attach it, we'll do the side of her body, right? So let's go. So side of her body curves down like so. And what we can see of her neck, right, to join the shoulder to her neck, she has like a furry sort of collar, bumpy, furry collar coming around. It goes all the way up to the other side, so it's like just like you're thinking cloud or bumpy sort of neck snood kind of thing. And then the inside of it here. Like so, and we can see some kind of neck muscles and shadows inside here, right? So like a shadow underneath her chin. the shadow here. Like so, I think I'll leave it there. Right, so then the other side of her body. So just comes out from this snood, right? So the front of her chest. So it sticks out like so, comes past that piece of hair that I said goes down behind her body, right? And then her chest will curve out and around down off the bottom of my page. Of course, you have more room. You can go across underneath to the other side and back up into her armpit. So like the other side of her arm, her costume is just here, right? Like that, and then this goes down to there, and then her armpit line. So if you had more room, you could go underneath and bring it up into the armpit, sort of here, and this is like armpit sort of area. Maybe some hatching in there. And then her collarbone sort of comes across and up. Or like her chest muscle, because she is fairly muscly. Like that. So she has like a crescent moon on the front of her costume. It's because she's, I guess, a rabbit kind of thing. It curves around. Like that, on the other side. Down like so. And there could be some hatching just here. And like this is dark just here on the other side. It's this sort of area on her costume, just on that side as well. Okay, so her other arm goes up and it's making the same sort of pose as this one, except it's kind of pointed off to the other side, right? So the glove itself comes out from her ear. Just say there. And then we go back up into there. Couple of spikes. Bring them across. So we're going sort of diagonal up this way now. Like so. And then this kind of curves back around into here. Like so. So this is where her arm goes in. So we'll bring that down and then we'll deal with the hand. So like her wrist comes out here, like that. Forearm comes down and kind of twists in. Forearm comes out the other side, down like so, and then her elbow would stick off. And again, when you're doing elbow, try work with angles, right? Like that. I know in real life they're round, but when you're drawing them, it can help. Just if you deal with angles, see? So change direction suddenly. And then her tricep curves up and around like so. And then her armpit, just in here. And we can see like her chest muscle, just there. Some more armpit, and there might be some hatching. Just under there. Might be a little bit of hatching actually here as well. Right, so bicep curves there. To there and hatching. Like so. Oh, the underside of her glove, actually. I forgot that. So it like comes just like the underneath of it, just in under there. And the underneath here too. It's like the inside part underneath there. So then the other hand, right? So tricky. The tricky other hand. So we can do the thumb first. So it kind of comes up like so. Curves around like that. Okay. So this is the thumb. So it comes back down. Like so. And then some lines coming around like that. And then we have that line for the top of the glove, like on these here. It kind of continues down the back. So then her hand goes this way, right? So palm of her hand, say there, and the back of her hand comes out like that. So the back of her hand will run up and join her index finger. Goes up like so. And then this will curve around the top. And this will go down into her thumb. Like so. Like so. And then the next finger, up, around, down to about there. Maybe a bit longer, actually. Yeah. Like so. And then the top of the glove, like so. Next one out, down. It's kind of skinnier. See how skinny it's getting? Because the hand is turned away, so we're getting a bit of perspective now. And then we have a bump right here. And finally, our little finger, last but not least, back down into here. And there might be some lines on the palm of our hand as well, some folds and stuff coming across. That is the basic. Oh no, we're not done. Sorry. Her ear. We forgot like the inside of her ear. So it comes down just behind here. The furry part. And then another bit comes down like so. And it's got some fur. Like the inside fur part. Just here. That was close. I nearly turned off the video. And the inside of her ear runs up this side. Some hatching there, inside there, and like a dark shadow portion just here. And something coming down this side, maybe. And there are, God, I forgot loads. There's some more hair lines coming down just this way. Going down, running down behind their back, and it comes out of her elbow. Just there. So there's more like hair texture lines and stuff down here. Like that. Okay. And maybe a bit more hair here. Okay, now I think that's it. Hope that's it anyway. So there you go. Miracle. Thanks for the request. Check out Patreon if you want to make requests that you want me to get to quickly. I always prioritize Patreon requests. I hope this was helpful. I know it is, it's tricky, it's not easy, because of the hands, basically, and probably her teeth and stuff, but I hope it was helpful anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.